Welcome to Bharat Vansh YouTube channel. Please like, comment, share and subscribe. Don't forget to press the bell icon.
Maurya Dynasty Series Part 4 Dharmashoka and Later Mauryans. After some years of Kalinga War, Ashoka turned towards Dharma and thereafter called as Dharmashoka. Ashoka followed the non-Buddhist tradition during his initial reign as emperor. His grandfather Chandragupta converted to Jainism and his father Bindusara became an Ajivika. He himself was in confusion of practicing many religions from the childhood. After the Kalinga War, Ashoka felt sad and wished to know about the religions which can make his mind calm and peace. First, he tried to understand Hindu, Jain and Ajivika traditions. Not convinced with them, he came across Buddhism for the first time when he saw Buddhist monk Samudra, an ex-merchant of Shravasti. Samudra was a prisoner in Ashoka's hell and came out miraculously. When Ashoka heard this, he visited the monk and impressed by Samudra's miracles. He became his follower and later a Buddhist. This story is mentioned in Divyavadana book. After converting to Buddhism, Ashoka sent monks to spread the teachings of Buddha all over the world, but never forced his subjects for the conversion. People were free to follow the religion they wished. Ashoka collected 7 out of 8 relics of Buddha and had kept their portions in 84,000 gold and silver boxes. He ordered for the construction of 84,000 stupas around his empire. Today, it is only some of the stupas are present, others being destroyed in period. The stupa at Sanchi was built in memory of his first wife Devi as her wish. He constructed stupas at Sarnath, Bodh Gaya, Nalanda, Takshila, Butkara, Sannati and many more. Some of the stupas were reconstructed or modified during later years. Ashoka established edicts at many places around his empire to publicize his new policies and about Buddha's teachings, which are called Dhamma. Edicts are the inscriptions on the huge or small rocks written in Prakrit or Pali language. Ashokan edicts are present in Junagadh, Gujarat, Dhauli, Odisha, and at many more places throughout India. Ashoka constructed pillars at many places across India like Greek emperors. 5 pillars were found at Rampurva, 1 each at Vaishali, Lauriya Araraj and Lauriya Nandangarh. 2 of Ashokan pillars were moved to Delhi from Meerut during the reign of Firoz Shah Tughlaq. Pillars are also found at Sankesa and Sarnath and Sanchi. The Sarnath pillar with the lion capital is India's national emblem. The chakra of Ashoka is present in the national flag. He did many public works such as construction of hospitals, study centers and animal sheds. He planted trees and groves on the sides of roads. The digging of wells and construction of water bodies and the rest houses for the travelers were done during his reign. He banned the killing of animals and reduced the tax burden on his subjects. He was called Priyadarshi by his people. Third Buddhist Council. Ashoka arranged the Third Buddhist Council in 240 BC at Pataliputra, his capital. The council was attended by more than 1,000 monks and presided by Moggaliputta Tissa, a Buddhist monk born at Magadha. The council is recognized and known to both the Theravada and Mahayana schools, though its importance is central only to the Theravada school. Buddhist scriptures mention the past lives of Ashoka. According to Mahavansha, Ashoka, Nigrodha and Tissa were brothers in a previous life. A Buddhist was looking for honey to cure another Buddhist who was sick. A woman directed the Buddhist to a shop owned by the three brothers. Ashoka donated honey generously and wished to become the ruler of Jambudvip for his act of merit. The woman wished to become the queen of the ruler. In later life, Ashoka became ruler and the woman born as Asandhi Mitra, his wife. According to Ashokavadana, Ashoka was born as Jaya in a family of Rajagriha. When he was a boy, he gave Gautama Buddha a dirt, imagining as food. The text mentions Jaya, born as Ashoka, who had a rough skin because of his wrong deed. Vijaya, an aide of Jaya, was reborn as Radha Gupta, his minister. Ashoka and his family. His first wife was Devi, and she lived in Ujjain and Vidisha till her death and followed Buddhist religion as she belonged to Shakya sect. Her son Mahindra and daughter Sanghamitra were sent to Sri Lanka to promote Buddhism by their father. Kauruvaki was Ashoka's favorite wife and mother of her only son Tivala. The names of Kauruvaki and Tivala are mentioned in many of the Ashokan inscriptions. Tivala died during his father's reign. Ashoka married Padmavati when he was the emperor. She died after giving birth to a son named Kunala. Ashoka's chief queen was Asandhi Mitra and raised Kunala as her own son since she was childless. She made Ashoka to turn towards Buddhism, and she was responsible for the construction of 84,000 stupas around the empire. She died when Kunala was a teen. Ashoka married Tishyaraksha to raise his teen son Kunala, who had lost his mothers. Ashoka had given kingship to her for 7 days, and she plotted against Kunala and treacherously blinded him by a royal order. Ashoka had a daughter called Charumati, who was married to Devapala, a ruler of Nepal. She is credited to have founded the monastery of Jabahil, which is known as Charumati Vihara and is one of the oldest Buddhist monasteries of Nepal. Ashoka died in 232 BC when he was 72, and it was his natural death. He was severely ill during his last days. He emptied the treasury by donating wealth to Buddhist Sanghas. He donated his personal funds and jewels to the Buddhist monasteries. On his deathbed, he had only a fruit to eat, which he donated to a Buddhist monk as his final donation. Legend states that his body burned for 7 days and nights during his cremation. After Ashoka's death, the Mauryan Empire declined rapidly. Dasharatha Maurya, 232 BC to 224 BC. He was a grandson of Ashoka and son of Tivara or Tivala, the favorite son of Ashoka. Dasharatha is described in the Vishnu Purana as the son of Suyashas. It has been suggested that Suyashas was an alternative name of Ashoka's son Tivara. He was probably born around 252 BC. This was based on information provided in Mauryan inscriptions that he became king when he was only 20. He succeeded Ashoka and became king around 232 BC. He was a weak monarch and not much of an able military leader. According to Jain text, the provinces of Saurashtra, Karnataka, Andhra and Mahishamandala region broke away from the empire shortly after Ashoka's death, but were reconquered by Dasharatha's successor Samprati. Dasharatha is known to have dedicated 3 caves in the Nagarjuni hills to the Ajivikas. 3 inscriptions at Gopika, Vadati and Vapaya caves refer to him as Devanampriya and state that the caves were dedicated by him shortly after his accession. Samprati, 224 BC to 215 BC. He was the son of Ashoka's blind son Kunala. He succeeded his cousin Dasharatha as emperor of the Mauryan Empire and ruled almost the entire present-day Indian subcontinent. Kunala was the son of Ashoka's queen Padmavati, but was blinded in a conspiracy to remove his claim to the throne by Ashoka's another wife Tishyaraksha. Thus, Kunala was replaced by Dasharatha as the heir to the throne. Blinded Kunala lived in Ujjain. Kunala married Kanchanamala and Samprati was born to them. Samprati was a Jain, unlike his predecessors who followed Buddhism. According to Jain text, some provinces broke away from the empire shortly after Ashoka's death, but were reconquered by Samprati, who deployed soldiers disguised as Jain monks. Samprati is regarded for his patronage and efforts to spread Jainism in East India. He was a disciple of Jain monk Suhasthi Suri. He was credited with actively spreading Jainism to many parts of India and beyond, both by making it possible for monks travel to barbarian lands and by building and renovating thousands of temples and establishing millions of idols. He built temples at Virangam, Palitana and Ujjain. He was also known as Jain Ashoka, as Ashoka who promoted Buddhism. Chalisuka, 215 BC to 202 BC. He was the son and successor of Samprati. The Garga Samhita mentions him as wicked ruler who cruelly exploited his subjects. Although he was a follower of Jainism, he was credited as cruel ruler by his subjects. Devavarman, 202 BC to 195 BC. He was a successor of Chalisuka and believer in Buddhist tradition. Shatadhanvan, 195 BC to 187 BC. He was son and successor of Devavarma. He followed Jainism. Brihadratha, 187 BC to 180 BC. He was the last ruler of Mauryan dynasty. He was son of Shatadhanvan. He followed Buddhism unlike his father. During his reign, the Mauryan territory centered on the capital of Pataliputra considerably had shrunk from the times of Ashoka to Brihadratha. During his reign, in 185 BC, there was a foreign invasion by Demetrius, a Greco-Bactrian ruler on northwestern part of Indian subcontinent. The weakness and the bad rule of the king provoked his commander to go against him and formed a group against the king. He was killed by his senapati Pushyamitra Shunga during a military parade in the capital. By his death, the Mauryan dynasty came to an end.
This concludes the history and genealogy of Maurya dynasty. Hope you liked this video. Please like, share, comment and subscribe. Don't forget to press the bell icon.
Subscribe to the channel and watch videos on history and genealogy of Indian dynasties.